Hey, what's up guys, it's Yvonne, and in this video I want to show you the super easy way to set up dynamic e-commerce values in your Google Tag Manager account. This is absolutely essential, especially if you're running an e-commerce business, and of course your purchase amount, currency, transaction ID, and so on can vary purchase to purchase. So if you follow what I show you in this video, all these values will be updated dynamically for you. Now, this specific method that I'm showing you in this video will work only if you're using Google Tag Manager and WordPress, because we'll be installing a plugin that will make everything a piece of cake for you. Now, this will work the same whether you're running ads on Facebook, Google, Microsoft, Pinterest, TikTok, literally any of these different traffic networks. As long as they have the option to add dynamically updated values, you will be able to use what I show you in this video to get that set up. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. So I'm going to assume that you guys already have a Google Tag Manager account. And by the way, these are the variables that I'm talking about: e-commerce currency, shipping, tax, transaction ID. Once you input these into your specific tag, they will be dynamically updated. And I'm gonna show you how to set that up. And then of course, I'll show you how to test it so you can actually see what it looks like firsthand. Now, I'm also going to assume that you guys obviously have WordPress. So the first thing we're gonna need to do is install this plugin. So let's click on add new plugin. I already have it installed, but I'm just gonna show you guys anyway. So it's super easy. It's called GTM for WordPress, spelled with the number 4. And it's gonna be this one right here, okay? So you're just gonna install it. You're gonna install and then activate it, okay? And then once you do that, once you activate it and install it, you're gonna click on settings over here. And I'm assuming you already have WooCommerce. If you're doing e-commerce, of course you would have that. And then you would need to enter your Google Tag Manager ID here. You say off right over here. That should be off by default. And then if you go to integration, you go to WooCommerce, you need to checkmark this option. Okay, this is important, because if you don't have this checkmarked, you will not have the data values pre-populated for you. So you need to select track e-commerce over here. Then scroll down. You need to select exclude tax from revenue, since these are values that are going to be automatically separated out, and then exclude shipping from revenue. Okay, and then scroll down, hit save changes, and you're good on this front. Okay, so you don't have to do anything else here with WordPress. Now, the other thing you have to do is, I'm going to give you a link in the description of the video, is head over to this site, gtm4wordpress.com, blah, blah, blah. I'll link that in the description again, make it easy for you guys, and then scroll down. And you need to save this container template, okay? That's important. And then we're gonna need to import it here in our Google Tag Manager account. So you're gonna click on admin, you're gonna click on import, and you're going to import that file. So you come in here, you right click this file, you say save link as, and then I gave it a name. It got saved right over here into the Chrome browser. We're gonna come back in here, and then what you come in and do is simply come in here and select that file. And then you're gonna click on merge, and then you're gonna say rename, okay? You don't want to overwrite anything, because if you already have tags that I don't know which tags you have, I don't want you guys to delete those and have those overwritten. So we're simply gonna merge, so we're gonna have this new container added to our existing one, okay? Now, I'm not gonna add it because I already have one. So all you're gonna do is you're gonna click on add to workspace. And let me just show you what that's gonna look like. Once you add that, you're gonna see all of these variables here, okay? All of these variables that are automatically populated for you via this integration that we have with the plugin and with this additional container. So all of this is done automatically. You can click on any one of them, you can see what they did. They basically pull the data automatically from the data layer. The data layer is this JavaScript container, which contains all of these values. So what this plugin and this container does is they automatically come in there, they know what the value names are for these different values, such as currency, transaction ID, so on, and then they just name them and they make it super easy for you. So that's why we're using this plugin and we're importing this container. So once you do that, let's head back over into tags and let me just show you how you can actually use them, because once you do that, you're pretty much done. The rest of it is now just a piece of cake, as if the beginning part of it wasn't. So let's click on Facebook purchase, for example. So now if we want to add these values, if you recall in one of the previous videos that we did, where we set up the Facebook pixel using Google Tag Manager, I'm gonna link the video in the description as well if you wanna see that. We added these values because we didn't have the dynamically updated values yet. But now what we can do, now that we have them, is we can delete it, we can delete it. We could come in here, we can search for e-commerce value right here. We can search for e-commerce currency right here. And that's it. That's it. Piece of cake. So we're, of course, going to test this. I'm going to show you what that's going to look like. We're going to be using our website with a bunch of different products so we can actually see. But you can use this anywhere now, okay? So let's look at Google Ads, for example. You have Google Ads, you can come in here. If you're not sure how to set up Google Ads conversion tracking with Google Tag Manager, let me know in the comments. I'll make a video for that. But over here, for example, you see conversion value. So you come in here and you say conversion value. You see transaction ID. You come in here, you say transaction ID. You see currency code. You come in here, you say currency code. Where is it? Am I blind? There you go. Okay, so that's it, guys. You do the same exact thing now, no matter what you're using. Again, Microsoft, Twitter, Pinterest, whatever it is you're doing, TikTok ads, the same process applies, okay? Wherever they allow you to add these dynamically updated values, that's where you would add them. So let's click on preview. Let me now show you what that's gonna look like. So we're gonna test both on the Facebook side and on Google Ads side, just to show you that it works on various different platforms, not just one. And of course, just as it works on these, it's gonna work everywhere else. So I clicked on preview mode. That's our general typical debug mode. We're gonna click continue, make sure the page loads. So let's come down here. Let's select maybe some products. Sorry, I meant to minimize it. And then let's just drag it a little bit lower there. So let's come in here and let's just add some different products so we can see that the values will indeed be added dynamically. So let's add this one to cart. Let's come back to shop. Let's find some other products that we like. Let's find, what can we find? What are some products with some weird values so that we can check that those values will be updated? So these, right? Okay, so we have two. So let's view cart. We should now have these two, so the total price should be $64.80, okay? So let's check, let's confirm, let's proceed to checkout. Let's come down and I'm using this test card here, let's just place the order. So the total should be $64.80. This will not be reflected in your Facebook Pixel Helper yet because we didn't save the Google Tag Manager, so it's just gonna show the old data or just no data at all. But if we hop on over here, if we click on purchase, we're gonna see that the Google Ads sale pixel fired. And if we go to summary, we'll also see that the Facebook purchase fired, right? So if we click on purchase, we click on the Google Ads one, if we click on show more and we click on values, we're gonna see the value here, 6480, the currency code and the conversion ID. Sorry, not the conversion ID, the transaction ID. This is important because if somebody refreshes the page, right? You don't want that to count as two conversions. So the transaction ID is important for you to have, one of the reasons why these dynamically updated values are so important. So if we go back into summary and we click on Facebook purchase, we should see those values here as well. So e-commerce value, e-commerce currency. Okay, so it's not gonna tell you the values, it's just gonna say e-commerce value, e-commerce currency. But if you come on over into purchase, you go to variables, you'll see that the currency is USD, and the value is 6480, okay? So all that information has been successfully passed through. If you wanna check this via the Facebook Pixel Helper as well, then you just save changes and then it's gonna show up on this helper extension. So when you click on purchase, it's gonna show you those values that were passed through. But we do see everything here in Google Tag Manager, so we know it's working. We see the sales have been passed, and for this one, it's gonna show you all those values, all right? So that's how you add these dynamically updated values. No matter what the purchase price is, that's what's going to show up, and this is gonna work regardless of whether you're using Google or Facebook, or like I said, any other traffic network, it's gonna work the same. So once we do that, we can hit submit. Let's just finish this strong. We're gonna say dynamic e-commerce values. We're gonna say publish, and there you go. So that's what I wanted to share with you guys here in this video. This is just a part of what I cover in my entire membership site. If you guys go to yvonnemeta.com/all-courses, this is one of the lessons in my analytics and tracking module, where I go over how to set up tracking via Tag Manager and Google Analytics, as well as any other traffic network sources so that you can accurately track your data. So this is one of the 7 modules which I cover in my membership site. If you guys want to be the first to know when it's out, just enter your name and email and I'm going to email you right away as soon as the membership site is out. And that is all. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.